ছাত্র কই এসব?
এখনো এখন অব্দি কেউ জয়েন করেনি, ওয়েট, সবাই বোধ হয় কলেজ টলেজ গেছিল, ভেরিফিকেশন ছিল আর কি, ফিরছে বোধ হয় আস্তে আস্তে।
ও কলেজ অফিস খোলা না
হ্যাঁ, সেই জন্য বোধ হয়।
তো, ভালো কথা। তোর ভোটের ডিউটি পড়লো?
তোর কথা পরিষ্কার আসছে না, ইয়ে হচ্ছে।
সবাই বলছে, এবার শুনতে পাচ্ছিস?
শুনতে পাচ্ছি কিন্তু কথা দুটো হচ্ছে বোধ হয়।
ইকো হচ্ছে,
হ্যাঁ, ইকো হচ্ছে,
এখনো হচ্ছে,
এবার পরিষ্কার, এবার এসছে।
এবার ঠিক আছে। দেখ,
হ্যাঁ
হ্যালো।
হ্যাঁ হ্যাঁ, ঠিক আছে ঠিক আছে, ওকে ঠিক আছে।
অ্যাকচুয়ালি ওই ওয়েব ক্যামটা মুখের সামনে না ধরলে,
দাঁড়া একটু ওয়েট করে যা, 5-10 মিনিট ওয়েট কর, ওই আস্তে আস্তে জয়েন করছে এক করে সবাই।
হ্যাঁ হ্যাঁ ঠিক আছে। বলছি তোর ভোটের ডিউটি পড়লো?
না, পড়েছে কিন্তু যাইনি, যাবো না আর কি,
জানি মানে,
যাবো না কেন, ওই অনেক রকম কারণ আছে, সে পরে বলছি। হ্যাঁ,
আচ্ছা
আপাতত
আচ্ছা
আপাতত হয়ে যাক তারপর।
ঠিক আছে।
আচ্ছা, আমার মনে হয় আমরা আপাতত শুরু করি, আমরা শুরু না করলে মুশকিল হয়ে যাবে। আস্তে আস্তে যখন আরো বাকি লোকজন আসবে তখন আস্তে আস্তে জয়েন করবে, আমি অ্যালাউ করে দেবো, কোনো অসুবিধা নেই। এই তো আসছে আস্তে আস্তে, তো অ্যাট লিস্ট 3 পিপল আর দেয়ার, সো নো প্রবলেম, সো উই ক্যান স্টার্ট। সো অ্যাজ ইউ নো, আই থিঙ্ক আই হ্যাভ ডিসকাসড উইথ ইউ দ্যাট দিস ইজ আ এক্সটেনশন লেকচার ফ্রম ডিপার্টমেন্ট অফ ম্যাথামেটিক্স, অ্যান্ড টুডে উই হ্যাভ শ্রী জগন্নাথ বিশ্বাস। He is an assistant professor from Belur Lal Baba College, assistant professor of mathematics. So he will talk about mean value theorems. As you know, I actually, I can say about first semester that you have these mean value theorems in your syllabus. And I think you all know continuity, differentiability, all these things. So mean value, since you know all these things, so now you have to know this mean value theorems and their importance and their applications, geometrical significance, and lots of things like this. And I think Sri Jagannath Bishas will sir will discuss those things with you, and maybe any many other things also. So I am handing over my responsibility to Sri Jagannath Bishas, and I will ask him to start his and deliver his lecture.
Thank you, Dr. Rajasen. As you all know, the topic of today, but before starting the topic, I want to say something about your sir. You are very fortunate to have a teacher like him in your college, and I am very overwhelmed that I have invited, I have been invited in your college. Okay, sorry for interruption. Am I audible now?
Yes, sir.
Yes, thank you. So, sorry for the interruption. So, today I have been told that I have to give a lecture on something from your syllabus. So, I since the your university is, I think Bharat State University, and my university is in Calcutta. So I have to check out the syllabus, and it was purely differential calculus for your first and third semester, I think. So I selected something, and in a very short time, I had to prepare some slides also so that you can visualize my lecture. So today I am going to discuss about MVT, that is mean value theorem, and its application. Now the question is, why I choose the topic? Because we all know mathematics is a very boring subject for those at least who have not mathematics as honors. So all of you, I think, have some other subject as honors, no? Here are only two or three persons, so can you introduce yourself for just a friendly environment? I think Shreya Ghosh is there. Which is your department? Hello?
Sir, Computer Science Honors.
Thank you. And Shima Chaudhary?
Sir, I'm also from Computer Science Honors. I'm from third sem.
Okay. And Rimi Ghosh? Hello, am I audible? I think
okay. Sir, Rimi Ghosh, general student, physics, chemistry, math.
Okay, So I think computer science, from computer science, there are two students. So I became confused to choose a subject today. And lastly, I choose something which is a little bit of interest. And it has some very so many applications in mathematics itself. So let's start. Can you see my screen?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. So myself, Professor Jagannath Vishas, and this is my email ID. For further communication, you can contact me here. So I am from Lal Baba College, Calcutta University. So before going to mean value theorem, the basic one there is also a theorem which is named after French mathematician Michael Rolle, and this theorem was discovered in 1690. That means around 300 years ago. So this is very basic, and if you want to understand mean value theorem and its further instances, you have to definitely understand the importance of Rolle's theorem. Okay. So in every theorem of mathematics, there are some preliminaries, some requirement, and here is also the requirement is the function f should be continuous in a closed interval AB. Can you see the picture below the slide? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Hello? So you can see the this line is x-axis here, and somewhere here would be y-axis. So upon the x-axis, this from A to B, this is an interval. A closed interval is assumed here, and in this interval, the function is everywhere continuous. Okay. So if you know about continuity of a function, easily you can understand the continuous function is always like this. Now, that means there is should be no any disturbance, no any gap in the graph of that function, as you know. And the function is also derivable, that is it has a derivative at each point of the interval AB. Okay, so in every point you can find the derivative. Now the basic question is, can I ask you something? What can you say about differentiability of a function? If I am saying here, the function f is differentiable all over the interval. What can you say from this line? This line has a derivative at each point of the open interval AB. Can you say some words? So, anybody? Hello? Shreya, Shima, Rimi, anybody? Can you say one or two words about differentiability of the function in the open interval AB? Okay, don't worry. So the differentiability means, if I want, suppose in this point, suppose corresponding to this point, if I draw a perpendicular from here to here, can you see my cursor of the mouse? Hello? Hello?
Yes, sir, we can see.
Yes, if I ask you some question, yes, hello or something, you please respond. Unless I will understand that nobody can hear me. Okay. So don't worry about the question and answer. If you are try to not answering anything, no problem. I will help you here. That is a purely friendly environment. That is no examination is going on here. Okay, so don't worry. So suppose here is a point. Here is a point. Let me something like suppose this is a point. Okay, this is a point. And suppose this is a the point is greater than a. Yes, so let draw a perpendicular here to here. Okay, so if I want to draw a tangent, okay, then what will be the tangent like this from here to here? Okay, is it okay? Can you understand the meaning of the tangent?
Yes, sir.
Hello? Yes, sir.
Yes. So if I want to draw tangent in any of the point of the graph between these two point A and B, that is possible. Okay. So this is the meaning that the function has a derivative at each point of the open interval AB. Now this is the prerequisite to satisfy the condition of our Rolle's theorem. The Rolle's theorem is saying that if the function has these two properties, that is the function is continuous in the interval AB closed and is derivable in the interval AB open, and also FA equal to AB, that means with respect to A, the height of the function is what? FA. And with respect to B, the height of the function is AB, isn't it? So if these two value are same, okay, you can see the height of the point A from the x-axis and the height of the point B from x-axis are same. So if these three conditions are satisfied, then Rolle is saying that there is at least one point in these open interval A and B, okay, which satisfy the condition f dash equal to 0. So here we are assuming some point C between the open interval AB for which f dash C equal to 0. Now, can you see that why the tangent is like this here for this presentation? Anybody can say about it? Why the tangent is like this? Not like this or not like this? Any inclinedness are not is not here. The tangent is like parallel to the x-axis. Why is it so? Can you say anybody? Hello?
Sir, here C is the main point in between A and B.
What are you saying? I didn't understand. তুমি যদি বাংলায় বলতে চাও বলতে পারো, কোনো অসুবিধা নেই। হ্যালো
স্যার, এখানে এ আর বি এর মধ্যে সি পয়েন্টটা মেইন হিসাবে আছে আর কি।
কি হিসাবে আছে?
সি পয়েন্ট আর কি অ্যাভেলেবল এ আর বি এর মধ্যে ডিফারেনশিয়েশনের জন্য।
না, সেটা তো অবশ্যই, এখানে তো বলছি যে দেন দেয়ার ইজ অ্যাট লিস্ট ওয়ান পয়েন্ট সি ইন দিস ওপেন ইন্টারভ্যাল এবি সাজ দ্যাট এফ ড্যাশ সি ইকুয়াল টু জিরো। না, আমার কোশ্চেন হচ্ছে যে এখানে যে আমি এফ ড্যাশ সি ইকুয়াল টু জিরো লিখে এই যে ট্যানজেন্ট এঁকেছি একটা, দেখতে পাচ্ছ এই ট্যানজেন্টটা এরকম প্যারালাল কেন হলো? আমি এরকম করে কেন আঁকলাম না, বা এরকম করে কেন আঁকলাম না? ইজ দেয়ার এনি রিজন বিহাইন্ড ইট অর ইজ ইট অনলি সাম কোইন্সিডেন্স? এই রেসপেক্টে কি তুমি কিছু বলতে পারো? আমি সেটাই জিজ্ঞেস করেছি।
স্যার, হিয়ার ইজ আ ম্যাক্সিমাম পয়েন্ট অ্যাট দ্য আপার এজ
অ্যান্ড ও আচ্ছা, মানে ইউ আর সেইং দ্যাট দ্য পয়েন্ট ইজ অন একদম এট দ্য ম্যাক্সিমাম পয়েন্ট, সো দ্য ট্যাঞ্জেন্ট ইজ লাইক দিস, আর ইউ সেইং দ্যাট?
Yes, sir.
ওকে, অ্যাকচুয়ালি দ্য ম্যাটার ইজ সামথিং লাইক দ্যাট, বাট দ্য হিয়ার ইজ দ্য অ্যান্সার শুড বি, সিন্স এফ ড্যাশ সি ইকুয়াল টু জিরো, নাও হোয়াট ইজ দ্য রিয়েল মিনিং অফ ডেরিভেটিভ? হোয়াট ইজ দিস? এফ ড্যাশ মিনস ডেরিভেটিভ অফ এফ এক্স at x equal to c, isn't it? Now this is c point, and at c point means not this point, in this point. Okay, so at c point means for x equal to c, what is the point corresponding to this? C comma fc. Okay, this is c comma fc because the function is fx. So for any point here, the ordinate should be f of that, isn't it? So this is my C point. So corresponding to this point, the perpendicular meet the graph at the point, and the coordinate of the point should be C comma, suppose this is my x axis. So suppose here is the x axis, y axis. Suppose this is my y axis. Okay, so this is my origin. So from here to here, this is what? C. And from here to here, that is FC. Okay, this is FC.
Yes, sir.
Yes. So this point should be a coordinate. Always, every point is a coordinate. Should has a coordinate. So
yes, sir.
What is the coordinate of this point? The
C and FC.
Abscissa is C, and the ordinate is FC. Very good. Yes, I want like this type of environment. You just say some, speak out. You just speak out. আমরা এখানে একটু গল্প করতে বসেছি, কোনো লজ্জার কিছু নেই, ভয়ের কিছু নেই. ওকে, সো অ্যাট দিস পয়েন্ট, সিন্স দ্য ডেরিভেটিভ ইকুয়াল টু জিরো, নাও অ্যাজ আই সেড আর্লিয়ার, দ্যাট ডেরিভেটিভ মিনস অ্যাট হিয়ার ইজ দ্য লাইন ওয়াজ দ্যাট হ্যাজ এ ডেরিভেটিভ অ্যাট ইচ পয়েন্ট অফ দ্য graph of the function in the open interval AB. What is the meaning of this line? The meaning was at every point we can draw a tangent. Okay, at each point we can draw a tangent. So point tangent, but my y cross to x cross equal to 2. Now, if derivative equal to zero, that means what? That means rate of change of the function at this point is nothing. Matlab, that is the function is not increasing, neither increasing nor decreasing. Okay, so here the tangent will be flat. Okay, but if I draw a tangent here, the tangent will be what? The derivative will be greater than zero, because as you can recall, if you recall from the higher secondary of mathematics, can you recall this f dash x is equal to tan theta? Can you recall this?
Yes, sir.
Yes, very good. Then what is the theta? If I draw a tangent in this point, and if the tangent meets the x-axis here, then this angle is theta. And the value of the derivative is equal to tan theta for this theta. Okay, for this theta. So as you can see, up to perpendicular 90 degree, the tan theta is from 0 to infinity. And after that, if the tangent is like this or this, then tan theta would be less than 0, negative. Okay, and for line like 45 degree angle, that is something like this, the tan theta is what? Tan 45 means 1. Below this, tan theta is less than 1. And if the tangent would be like that, the tan theta would be greater than 1. Okay, and up to when the tangent is like perpendicular to the x-axis, the tan theta value of the tan theta would be plus infinity. So this becomes hazy, so let's discard the drawings. Okay, so now I am saying that for that reason, since they are the maximum point, and since f dash c equal to 0, so tan theta equal to 0. Now when tan theta equal to 0, when theta equal to 0, isn't
yes,
it?
Sir.
Yes, yes, very good. If tan theta equal to 0, then theta equal to 0. So theta equal to 0 means which angle is 0 here? Because if I try to extend the tangent and try to meet the tangent with x-axis, the angle between this line and the x-axis will be 0. But here, since the line is parallel, so it will never intersect the x-axis. So that angle between these two lines would be 0. So the tangent is 0 here because the derivative was 0. So yeah, okay. So this was my question. So Rolle is saying that if the function is through all over the interval, if the function is continuous and is a derivative in the open interval, then and fa equal to fb, that means the end point producing the same ordinate in the end, fa equal to fb, then f dash c equal to 0. And what is c? C is any point between a and b. Now any point means nothing related to that. If I want to imagine every point here, all the points should be like this. No, there is at least one point. অন্তত একটা পয়েন্ট আমি ওর মধ্যে খুঁজে পাবো যার জন্য এই ঘটনাটা ঘটবে, ঠিক আছে? ডেরিভেটিভটা ইকুয়াল টু 0 হবে, বা ওই পয়েন্টে যদি ট্যাঞ্জেন্ট আঁকা হয় সেটা এক্স অ্যাক্সিসের প্যারালাল হবে। দ্যাট ইজ মাই রোলস থিওরেম। ওকে, নাও বিফোর গোয়িং টু দ্য মিন ভ্যালু থিওরেম, উই আর নাও এ লিটিল we have a knowledge, little knowledge about Rolle's theorem. But what is the application of Rolle's theorem? The very first application of Rolle's theorem should be mean value theorem in your book. But before that, if you can remember in your theory of equation, do you have theory of equation in your syllabus? Hello?
Yes, sir.
আছে ওখানে থিওরি অফ ইকুয়েশনের মধ্যে, ওখানে দেখবে একটা টপিক আছে বিটুইন এনি টু রুটস অফ এ ফাংশন দেয়ার ইজ এ রুট অফ দ্য ডেরিভেটিভ অফ দ্য ফাংশন। ইফ ইউ ক্যান রিকল দ্যাট থিওরেম ইউ উইল ফেস দেয়ার ইন থিওরি অফ ইকুয়েশন চ্যাপ্টার, দ্যাট ইজ এ ডিরেক্ট অ্যাপ্লিকেশন অফ রোলস থিওরেম। অ্যান্ড অলসো সাম বেসিক সিচুয়েশন situation constant function এর কোন উদাহরণ দিতে পারো? হ্যালো, can you give any example of constant function? Yes,
fx equals to 1.
Very good, very good. Fx equal to 1, that means fx is equal to any constant, 1 or 2 or any number, any real number. So that would be a constant function. Now my I am saying that if the function is constant, then what will be the graph of the function?
Parallel to the x-axis.
Very good. Yeah. Like this. Suppose this height is 1. So the graph representing the chord AB should be the function of the line is fx equal to 1. So for these type of functions, if I find the derivative of the function, then what will be the value? The value will be 0 f dash x equal to 0 for constant function. Now, what is the reason behind it? The reason is Rolle's theorem. Okay, because the reason is Rolle's theorem. Every type, there are very so much application of Rolle's theorem in our mathematics. So before going to the application part, actually let's understand the basic of Lagrange mean value theorem. Lagrange mean value theorem is saying that if the function is continuous in an interval, the same condition as Rolle's theorem, okay, the same condition Rolle's theorem, just the difference is this part is not there. Here is the third part was also assume that f equal to fb. Okay, so let's discard it and just stick to the first two condition. The condition is if the function is continuous everywhere in the closed interval ab and has a derivative at each point of the open interval ab, then this will happen. I am not saying the mathematical part, just let's understand the graphical part first. Okay, so what is this? Let's first understand the graph so that we can easily understand the mathematics. So this is our AB. This is an interval, okay, and FA and FB is different. As you can see, FA is very much smaller than FB. So the third condition of Rolle's theorem is not satisfied here. So what I am saying, if I connect the point A and the point B, then the chord AB, as you can see the chord, there will be a point C between the open interval AB for which the corresponding point CFC has its tangent which will be parallel to this chord. Do you understand my statement?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Bangla bolbo ekbar. Hello.
Na sir, English e bolun.
Okay. Very good. So the Lagrange mean value theorem is saying that if I take a function, and this curve is the function f here. As you can see, this is fc for corresponding to c. So this point is cfc. So Lagrange is saying that if the function is continuous on this closed interval ab and derivable, that means has derivative at each point in the open interval ab, then the tangent at any point at c, any point c between the open interval, the tangent would be parallel to the chord ab. Now in the Lagrange mean value theorem statement, this type of statement you can't find. This is my geometrical significance. Okay, so what will be the mathematical statement there? See, if the tangent at the point C is parallel to the chord AB, now what can I say from here? What can I say? What is the meaning of parallelness in mathematics? Can you say anything about parallelness from two parallel straight line? What geometrical features we can predict? Can you say anything?
When we proceed, they means they never meet at any point, and the angle between them is zero.
That means, are you saying that if I try to find the angle between them, the angle will be zero?
Yes.
Yes. Now that is good. That is the meaning of parallel line. Anything else? Anybody?
Distance between them is equal.
Everywhere. Very good. Anything else? Anybody?
Sir, angles of both straight line will be same
with x-axis. Angle between what? between them. Suppose this, there are two lines, this line and this line. So from the you just take this example of this, from the two state parallel state line, what geometrical features we can predict here? So one of you has said that the distance of them is always same in everywhere, and in another member has said that the angle between them is zero, and I think three students are here. Yeah, no, Rimi, Shima, and Shreya. Okay.
If we draw a perpendicular to both this one, then the angle made with this perpendicular and the line will be equal.
Okay, thank you. So thank you for your participation, and I am very glad that all of you has talked about this. Thank you. So see, whatever you say is absolutely correct, but I am trying to listen something about the geometrical features like slope. Do you have any idea about slope of a straight line? Do you know what is slope?
And their slope will be equal, same.
Yes. What is the slope?
Slope 10 theta.
10 theta, very good. Slope means if I extend the lines and try to meet them with x-axis, then the angle will be same. Suppose this is my, this angle is the, if this is theta, then theta 1, then tan theta 1 is the slope of this line. And if I try to extend this, this is the, is the slope this line. Okay, now can you say what is the difference between tan theta 1 and tan theta 2 here? They are same because theta 1 is also equal to theta 2. Okay, so I am trying to saying this, that the slope of these two parallel lines are same. Now, what is the method of finding the slope in mathematics from the straight line chapter of your high secondary? Can you recall the formula of slope? Hello?
Sir, repeat please.
Yes.
Sir, শুনতে পাইনি আরেকবার বলুন.
Oh.
Y2 minus y1 by x2 minus x1.
Yes. That is very good. So to write this, you have to know the coordinate of
coordinates.
The, yes. Now, can you see? Can you tell me what is the coordinate of this point B? If I know the coordinate of this point and A point, then we can find the slope.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. So what is the coordinate of this point?
X1, Y1.
No. See, what is this?
Actually, yes. It is A comma F of A.
This is B. Better?
B.
This is B.
B comma F of B.
Yeah, very good. And for this point, for A, capital A point, what is the coordinate of this point? A comma
F of A.
Very good. Now you can easily write the slope, obviously, I think. And that will be FB
minus FA
by
B minus A.
Very good. See, This is our slope of the chord. Okay, and this slope is equal to what? Sorry, this is a mistake. This will be F dash C. So FB minus FA by B minus A, what was that? This was our slope of the chord AB, isn't it? And F dash C is what? As you can, the tangent, this tangent is here, and the slope of the tangent is F dash C. Okay, because to find the slope, you have to either know the end point of a line segment, or if you don't know the lines end of the line segment, then you have to know directly the derivative of, you have to know the function and its derivative. Okay, so this is a function f, and at the point c the derivative would be f slope of beta c and slope of this line for b minus a by b minus a, as you said just earlier. So these two slope would be same. This is the actually a statement of Lagrange's involution. Okay.
Okay. Sir.
And in the second picture, as you can see, there are two points in which the tangents are parallel to the chord AB, where AB point is what? A capital A is the point of the graph with respect to the a first endpoint of the interval, and capital B corresponding to S1. Okay, so the meaning of these two picture is there is at least one point. I have Lagrange's involution theorem has said there is at least one point. So what is the meaning of at least? Maybe two or three points also, isn't it? So this is the saying of Lagrange's involution theorem. Okay, now. Okay, now we can use this formula and we can memorize this formula by a analogy of in physics. Here is an analogy I have quoted here. To exhibit a strong intuitive evidence for the truth of this formula, we may think of FT as the distance. FT, see, this is the distance traveled by a moving particle at time t. Okay, this is the distance. Then the quotient on the left, that in the chord, the slope of the chord, fb minus a by b minus a, this represents a mean speed or average speed. See, average speed in the time interval a comma b. What is the meaning of this time interval? Suppose a is 2 o'clock and b is 2.05. Okay, so after 300 seconds, so the distance traveled by the particle is ft. Then if the ft is the distance and t is the time, then f dash t represents what? The instantaneous speed at time t. Okay, so the equation asserts that there must be some moment when the instantaneous speed is equal to the average speed. Now what I am trying to say, that means you are starting your journey from the time in the clock at a pm. Okay, and at b pm you have reached a distance of ft. Okay, then according to the physics basic physics formula, the what will be the average speed? The total distance fb minus fa, what is that? Fb means the distance traveled by the particle at time b, at time t equal to b, minus the distance traveled from 0 to a. Okay, let's understand this. Like, suppose this is the timeline t and this is the 0, t equal to 0. Okay, that means time starts here, and suppose this is a and this is b. Now FA means what? FA means the distance from here to here, and FB means from here to here. Okay. Then what is the different meaning of FB minus FA? This distance from here to here. Now, actually, if I see that B minus A is the distance from here to here, but no, B and A are time. Okay. But the this is not the distance line. This is time line. So the corresponding function f represents the distance with respect to time t. So fa is this. This is fa and this is fb. So the difference between them is from here to here. So this in this time frame, the particle has gone from here. Elapsed time, then what will be the result? The result will be average speed of that particle, and that is equal to f dash c. Now, what is c? C lies in where? C lies between A and B. So suppose there is c, and if ft is the distance, then f dash t means speed at that point. So f dash c means at the c point the speed. High speed at the point C. Okay, so the theorem is saying that suppose you are starting your journey from the point A, and after that your speed is 5 km/s, then 10 km/s, then 15 km/s, and maybe your speed maybe 12 km/s for some hole in the road. You are braking your motorcycle, and after that you are speeding also. So for some ups and downs, you will calculating your average distance, and the Lagrange theorem is saying that in the journey of your motorcycle from the time A to time B, there will be some instance where at that point the real speed will be equal to the average speed your whole journey. Okay, can you understand my lecture here, what I am saying?
Yes sir.
Yes, very good. Then this is the actual geometrical significance or practical meaning of the and see in the last below of the slide I have written the this thing in a numerical example. If the average speed during trying to start a journey, and the very start of your journey, your speed should be zero. After that, suppose 1 km, 2 km, and slowly you have reached in between somewhere 100 mph, and after that you are speeding down your motorcycle. So suppose after calculating the total distance and total time, the average speed becomes 45 mph. Obviously, in the journey you should have reached somewhere your speed at 45 mph. Okay, that is obvious. So Lagrange theorem actually trying to say like this. Okay, and there are also some another important topic which is very important to remember, that this example you should always remember this example, fx equal to mod x. Okay, do you know mod x? What is the meaning of mod x? Hello.
The value of x both will be positive and negative.
Yes. Come again. Hello. Please repeat again. Hello.
Plus x or minus x.
Whatever be the value of x, the mod x will be always positive. Okay, whatever be the value of x, if x equal to minus 5, then mod x equal to 5, and if x equal to 5, then obviously x equal to 5. That means mod x always, mod x, the mod is the short form of modulus. Okay, the length of that number from 0, that is the meaning of mod x. Okay, so if, for this function, do you know the graph of the function? The graph of the function is like this. Suppose this is our x axis and y axis.
V shape graph.
V shape, very good, very good. And this is 45 degree. This is also 45 degree. Okay, this graph, as you can see, if I take a point minus 1 in the x-axis, the height will be f of minus 1, which is what? F of minus 1 means mod of minus 1, which is also 1. Okay, so capital A point, suppose this is my capital A point, this is capital A point. So what is the, this is minus 1. So the coordinate will be minus 1 comma 1. Okay, and suppose this is my 2, x equal to 2. So corresponding to this, suppose this is my b in the graph, the coordinate will be 2 comma f2. Okay, so f2 means what? Mod 2. Mod 2 means also 2. So there are two points, a and b. And if I try to justify the Lagrange mean value theorem here, what will be the result? See, the result will be FB minus FA by B minus A, which is equal to 1 by 3. But the problem is the derivative of the function is nowhere equal to 1 by 3. Okay, because from here to here, what is the line? Can you say what is the graph of this line only? What is the function? Fx equal to y equal to x line, this is, because this is 45 degree. Okay, this is y equal to x. So can you see the derivative? The derivative is 1 here in any point. The derivative is 1, and here in this side, the left hand side, the derivative is what?
Can you say minus 1?
Minus 1. Why? Because this equation of this line is y equal to
x equals to minus y.
Minus a, very good. Then the derivative is minus 1. And at that point, 0 point, what is the derivative? Tell me, what is the derivative of the function mod x at 0? Don't worry, whatever you are.
0. 0.
No, see, when you are trying to find the derivative of any function in such a situation where the graph is looking some awkward type, okay, so then try to think the derivative scenario in a symmetric manner. That means you have to think a little in the neighborhood. Okay, at the left hand side, as you can see, the limit of the function is what? The derivative at the left hand side is minus 1, and the derivative of the function at right hand side is plus 1. So at the point 0, the left hand derivative is minus 1 and the right hand derivative is plus 1. So you cannot conclude anything about the point origin for this function fx equal to mod x. Okay, so this function actually has no derivative at the point 0. It has no derivative. Okay, remember it. Everywhere in your life, this example will give you some, you know, very good, it will be a very helpful example, mod x. So, as you can see, anywhere in the graph, the derivative is either minus 1 or plus 1 or not existing. Okay, so what about 1 by 3? Is there any point in the graph, in any point between the interval minus 1 to 2, is there any point where you can find any point corresponding to which the derivative is 1 by 3? No, because I know the function very well here, mod x, which has derivative either minus 1 or plus 1 or not existing. Okay, so actually this Lagrange theorem is not justifying here. Now the question is why? Because as you remember, there were some prerequisite to justification of the Lagrange theorem. And what was the prerequisite? The function should be continuous everywhere and the function should be derivable everywhere. Okay, but the function is not derivable in this point. But if you take the function after 0 from like this point to 2, then there is no problem. There is no problem. Okay, you can justify them easily, because see, in this point, this is my first element, and this point, this is my F2, and the chord is like this, and in every point, the derivative is also like this. They will be parallel. Okay, so have you understood the topic here, the example?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Have you any question? Do you have any question? Okay, let's pause it. We have not so much time. After the Lagrange-Mindeleuf theorem, we will go to the application part. Before that, we are just telling that there is also a Mindeleuf theorem which is Cauchy's MBT, and this is nothing but very similar like the Lagrange MBT, which is f dash c into gb minus ga is equal to g dash c into fb minus a. See, g and f, there are two functions, and both the functions satisfies the conditions of Lagrange-Mindeleuf theorem. Okay, so today we will not go far for this theorem. Now let's jump to the application quickly. See, in every part of our mathematical grammar, we have countered many of these situations. That means, if the function is increasing, then the derivative should be positive. Have you faced like this? Anything? See, f dash x should be positive for f dx in the interval a b, then f is strictly increasing. Okay. So this type of scenario you will see in your future, or you have seen already. Okay, when we say that some function is, suppose this is x axis, y axis, suppose some graph is like this, okay, like this, like, okay. So am I audible, students? Are you there?
Yes, sir.
Okay. When the graph is increasing, that means it is going upwards, then f dash x is always greater than 0. Okay. And when it is decreasing in this part, the derivative will be less than 0. That means you can memorize those like this. When I will draw some tangent in the decreasing part, then the angle from with x-axis with it will be what, like this 135 degree or 140 degree, like this. So then tan theta will be negative. You can calculate in your calculator that obviously take the mode at degree and find tan 135 degree or on, that is any theta which is greater than 90, and you can calculate them with tan, then the result will be negative. Okay. So obviously from 90 degree to 180 degree, you can calculate them of tan, and the result will be negative. Okay, so I am saying that when the function is decreasing, the derivative will be less than 0, and the function is when increasing, the derivative will be greater than 0, which is a direct application of Lagrange-Mindeleuf theorem. Except Lagrange-Mindeleuf theorem, we can't prove them. Okay, the proof is very easy. It is the online proof, as you can see in my cursor. See, if suppose in this interval, we are taking any point x between this, justifying the Lagrange-Wingle theorem, then what will be the scenario? What will be the calculation? Fb minus fa by b minus a equal to what? Equal to what? F dash
x.
C, I said in the theorem. Now what is C? C was any point between the interval AB. Okay. So if the function is increasing in the interval, that means the interval would be like this. This is my A and this is my B. Okay. The function is increasing. Can you see? Function is always increasing in the interval. Then obviously FB is greater than FA. This is greater.
Yes.
So the difference of the numerator is positive. This is positive.
Yes, sir. And
B is also greater. So this is also positive.
Yes.
So the ratio of positive and positive is also positive. So F dash C is positive. And what is F dash C? C is any point between this A and B. So I am saying for every X in AB, C is also in AB. So C also may be the role of X. So I am saying that for any point between A and B, any X or any C, F dash of that will be positive. But see, if the function would be decreasing, okay, suppose from here to here, this is decreasing function, as you can see. This is going downwards from here to here. So suppose this is my A and this is my B, then what will be the greater? FA is very much greater than FB. So
yes, sir.
This difference, the numerator will be negative because FA is greater here. This is negative and this is positive. So ratio of some negative and positive, which is negative.
Also negative.
So F dash X is less than zero for every X between this interval. Okay. So this type of theory is very obvious, but we have to know that these theories are just came from Lagrange-Wingle theorem. Okay. This is very interesting. Okay. I will not so far today. There are so many examples when this is greater than zero at a point, but the function is nowhere increasing in the interval. I can write here. You have to check them in your home. That will be a laborious process today. Actually, the problem is, when the derivative of a function at any point is greater than zero, you have to check the positivity, not only that point, but also in a neighborhood of that point at least. In a neighborhood of that point, that means you are where the I am writing this in a here. Suppose there is fx equal to, can you see my handwriting is very poor here? Sorry for that. I am writing is with mouse. X, can you understand my writing?
Yes, sir.
X plus 2x square sine 1 by x. When x not equal to 0 and the function is 0 for x equal to 0. If we analyze this example, then you can see the derivative of the function at 0 is 1. Okay, that means f dash 0 equal to 1, which is greater than 0, but that is not enough to declare that the function is increasing anywhere beside the point 0. Okay. I can also give some example graphical. Suppose your graph is like this. Can you understand my graph here? Heart shape. Okay, suppose that it may be heart shape. Can you see, students?
Yes, hello? Sir.
Yes. Now, what is the derivative of that? This example will not be satisfied here because that derivative is not existed at the point 0. You should So this is an example where the function as derivative at 0 is 1, which is greater than 0. See, the derivative is positive, but we can't say anything that the function is increasing, because maybe at the point 0 the function, as you can see the formula, the graph is not easy to sketch in a one view. Computer can predict the curve. So f dash 0 is equal to 1, okay, and which is positive, but you should memorize that I have written here f dash x is greater than 0 for every x in AB. That is, if you try to imagine a point between A and never, then that means I am saying that you always verify that formula f dash x greater than 0 for every x in the interval. Then you can say that the function is strictly increasing on the interval. Okay, and let's take some quick example. Can you read that on yourself, the first line?
Yes, sir.
Read it, please.
Constant product minimum sum principle.
Constant sum and maximum product.
Maximum product principle.
Yes, yes. Given a positive number S, prove that among all choices of positive number X and Y, with X plus Y equal to S, the product XY is largest when X equal to Y equal to 4X. That is the condition. We have to find, this is the answer, x equal to y equal to 4s. This is largest when this is happening. So this type of problem can be only solved with the help of Lagrange mean value theorem. Okay, so let me how would you solve this type of problem? This is wrong. I think this would be s by 2. S by 2. Okay, the product will be s square by 4. Okay, then constant product minimum sum principle. Just one verse. Given a positive number p, prove that among all choices of positive number x and y with the product x y equal to p, the sum will be smallest. When? What is the value of x and y such that the sum is smallest? The answer is x equal to y equal to root p. Now, how can you solve this type of problem? See, we have to find the minimum value of x plus y, isn't it? Hello?
Maximum minimum.
Yes. Yes. Are you saying that maximum minimum chapter?
Yes, sir.
Yes, yes, yes. Exactly. So these type of problems actually the example of Lagrange interval theorem. And have you counted this problem with the LMBT? The arithmetic mean is always greater than or equal to the geometric mean. We all know about it. But this can be also solved by LMBT. Lagrange interval theorem. And let's go to an example, a physics problem last. A block of weight W is to be moved along a flat table. Okay, so this is my picture. This is my weight, whose weight is W, and this is going to push from this side with a force capital F theta. But the force is inclined, okay, the force is inclined up at the an angular direction. So this is approaching here, and the frictional force obviously is in the opposite direction of the movement of the body. Okay, now there is also a normal force capital N, which is the direction of N would be upper direction, capital N, normal
force. Yeah.
Yes, and this is my W, this is weight. Now, see, every force can be has a two component in perpendicular division, that is with respect to x, with along the x axis. The component of f theta is f theta cos theta, because this angle is theta, and this in this direction, that will be f theta.
F theta sin theta.
Sin theta. Okay. Now this is two component of the force f theta. Now since the body has weight downwards, so obviously the normal force will be act upwards. Now what will be the equation of motion? The equation of motion will be see the direction of n is what? Upwards. So let's forget about this. I don't write the equation as this way. I write my equations as the same at the same side of the equation. All the forces should be written. So direction of N is upwards, and direction of W is downwards. So they will be of opposite side. And F theta sine theta is the same direction as N. So if n is positive, then f theta will be also positive. Okay.
Yes.
Now this is equal to zero. This is equal to zero, and from that we can write n is equal to w will go that side, will be positive, and this part will be negative. So for this n equal to like this. Okay. This is normal force. Now the question was. Now the question was. Find the angle theta for which the propelling force needed to be overcome friction will be as small as possible. Okay, that means what is the minimum angle after which the propelling force will overcome the friction? okay, when just overcoming, just is equal and overcoming the friction, we have to find the angle. Okay, so what will be the solution of the problem? See, this is my N, capital N. Okay, and as we all know about the from physics, that frictional force is equal to is countering this force here.
F theta cos theta.
They will then now why mu n? Because frictional force formula frictional force, mu. What is mu? Frictional constant. And capital N is the normal force.
Yes, sir.
Now, because it will be time taking for me to write this equation in by cursor. Please, you can note in your khata. Mu into in first bracket w minus f theta sine theta equal to this f theta cos theta. Okay, and from that you have to find the value of f theta, which is I think equal to will be mu w by cos theta minus plus mu sine theta. Is it okay? Am I writing okay? Hello. Is it okay? The calculation is okay. F theta is equal to, we have to write mu into this w minus f theta sin theta is equal to f theta cos theta, because they are just the opposite direction in the horizontal direction. And from that line, you have to write the value of f theta. And I think this is the value of f theta. Now, the question was, what will be the minimum value of, what will be the value of theta where the propelling force will be just overcome the frictional force. Now, we have to just minimize the capital F function. So, if we try to minimize the capital F function, obviously, that denominator should be maximum.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Now, since the theta, range of theta is from where? From 0 to 90 degree.
Yes.
So between 0 to 90 pi by 2, I will check that the function in the this function. Let's nominate this function as g theta. Okay. So suppose this is g theta, which is cos theta plus mu sin theta. Cos theta plus mu sin theta. Now tell me, what will be the maximum or minimum value of g theta? Actually, you have to maximize the function. So you tell me about the maximum value of g theta in this range. See, g, I think at the point g is 0, this point,
sir, at the point 0, theta is equal to 0.
No, theta, theta equal to 0, g theta value will be what? 1, I think.
The cos 0, 1 hai jabe.
Sin theta 0, that means 1. And at this point, the value of g will be cos pi by 2 means 0, sin pi by 2 means 1, that is mu. Okay. And since this is cos theta and sin theta and mu is just a number, so this is a continuous function. So both of them has derivative everywhere in this range. So this g theta is satisfying the conditions of Lagrange's minimal theorem, and the both endpoint are difference value one and mu. So we can predict from LMBT that g pi by 2 minus g 0 by pi by 2 minus 0 is equal to g dash some theta. Okay, so what is g dash theta? Tell me, what is the derivative?
Minus sin theta plus mu cos theta.
Plus mu cos theta, very good. Mu cos theta. This is my g dash theta. So let's take the interval 0 to pi by 2, that is our in LMBT, that was AB interval. And between these, let some point is alpha angle. Okay. So according to LMBT, there will be a point alpha for which g dash alpha is equal to what? Is equal to what? G pi by 2 minus g 0 by pi by 2 minus 0. Isn't it? So I can say that g dash alpha will be
g pi by 2 minus g 0 by pi by 2 minus 0.
That is the value. What is the value? Mu minus 1 by pi by 2. So let's approach in a different way. G theta is in g dash theta is in our hand, so g dash alpha will be nothing but the value of theta will be alpha here. So minus sin alpha plus mu cos alpha. Okay, so minus sin alpha plus mu cos alpha, and so theta equal to alpha is the our critical point. Okay, theta equal to alpha is our critical point, and this g dash theta will be zero there, because in some point the this will be parallel to x axis. So g dash alpha, if g dash alpha equal to zero, then what will be the result? Minus sin theta plus mu cos minus sin alpha plus mu cos alpha equal to 0, that is value of mu is equal to tan alpha. And if I put that value in the value of g alpha, I think the value of g alpha will be root over 1 plus mu square. You can compute in your notebook. It will be very difficult for me here. Okay. See, this was right, g dash theta equal to minus sin theta plus mu cos theta. And let's take a point alpha in this interval, which is C point in our theorem. Then g dash alpha is the critical point where the maximum value or maximum value is attaining. So g dash alpha is equal to minus sin alpha plus mu cos alpha. And if that equal to 0, then we can find mu is equal to tan alpha. And in the form of g alpha here, cos alpha plus mu sin alpha, and if we put mu equal to tan alpha, I think the value will be 1 plus root over 1 plus mu square. By substituting the value of theta, we will find this like this. Okay, if mu equal to tan alpha, 1 plus tan alpha sec square, that is sec alpha 1 by cos alpha, like this something will happen. So what will be the value of f theta here? Mu w by root over 1 plus mu square. Okay, this will be the value of propelling force, such that the propelling force will overcome the friction. Okay, so this was our last application here. So if time permits, then in near future, obviously, we will go something. I cannot discuss. Today, this was our end of lecture. lecture today. Okay, thank you students for being patient so many time. Okay, thank you. Hello, Ajay sir, are you there?
Haan, achi, achi, come jump me. So,
yes, you can.
I think lecture is finished. So, I think the students, the number of students, actually they have problems. I think I guess. So someone told me that some net problems are there. So
it is very much interesting to have small little number of students because it is helpful for teachers also to teach them.
Yes, yes. So I think
any problem they are very good and yes. Very cooperative with me. Thank you.
Yes, I think they have some today have to submit some their form to the college and they have returned from the college very late. So they have told me and there's some net problems for connections are there. So I guess so no problem. This whole thing is recorded. So they can avail these recordings anytime. I see the lecture anytime, and I think Sri Jagannath Vishas, our sir, told you his email ID, and you can contact him for any problem. So, on behalf of Department of Mathematics, East Calcutta Girls College, I thanks Professor Jagannath Vishas for this wonderful lecture, and I hope we'll be able to call him again. And further discussing more topics in future. Okay, so I think we can close today's program here. So we are just closing today's program. So for the students, you can leave. No problem. So we are ending the session here.